What if the armies of the Lord picked up and dusted off?
Monday morning was a beautiful day to travel. We arrived in Honduras with a slight delay leaving Miami. Diane and Samuel met us at the airport. Diane informed us there was a delay in obtaining the needed paperwork to release the container with the sawmill in it from the dock. She suggested we spend Tuesday night in La Ceiba at an eco lodge called Jungle River. The next morning, we boarded the bus for a 4-hour ride to La Ceiba's Jungle River. On Wednesday morning, we decided to do the 3-hour jungle hike to the waterfall before we left for Trujillo. Roberto was our guide. Roberto was able to show us a lot of wonderful things in the forest. And to Megan, some not so wonderful things.
Turn back on the broken hearted. Some things are just meant to be. I still believe that we got a chance. Still believe that we got a chance to be.
After hiking for nearly 2 hours, we thought we were nearing our destination.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale, of a faithful friend. That started from the tropic corner of the sun. The mate was a mighty sailor and skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that day for a 3-hour tour. A 3-hour tour. The weather started getting rough. The tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of a fearless.
After about an hour, we finally reached our goal. Returning back to the lodge, we packed up and headed out in Scott's truck to Trujillo, with the boys riding in the back, rain and all.
How do you say rain in Spanish? Agua! Agua!
The next morning we arrived in Guadalupe Carne to meet with a sewing circle.
Esta es Lucy, aquí.
Lucy.
This is Lucy. She lives in that first house I showed you, the wooden house. This is Sylvia, where we parked the car. This is Amparo. She lives on the other side of the mountain, or the other side of the road over here. And this is Nicole, Nicolasa. She lives down, we didn't pass her house.
While the women were visiting with the sewing ladies, the men went to help with building a new water tank for the village. While in the village, we visited a farm and sampled some of the crops they grow.
I remember the times we spent.
Pardon me, I'm into my cat. Does anybody else want a piece?
I want to try some.
Hold in.
Take a cheese.
Yeah, you just take a little bite on it.
More like chewing.
Yeah, you just chew at it.
Like
chew a candle. Like that.
And then you're trying to chew the sugar out of it.
Uh-huh.
Think of it that way.
Wow.
Kind of like when you were a kid, you'd chew on grass or something.
It's really sweet. Yeah, it's sugar.
Right. Here's your sign.
Niños con la...
What is it? It's the same thing, but it's a green one.
Oh.
You can wash your hands.
We had a a chance to visit the church in the village that the last missions team from Upper Path Valley had started. Scott announced Thursday evening at dinner that he finally had all the papers in order for the container to be released. We would head to the dock in the morning. We enjoyed the rest of the evening with high hopes for Friday. We got to the dock Friday morning early, anticipating the release of the container, only to wait for over an hour to be told we needed yet another paper to be filled out. Friday evening, Scott came home after spending all day at the dock, personally overseeing the completion of the final paperwork. He announced the container was to be delivered to the local community center Saturday morning between 8 and 9. Saturday morning, we took a tour of the community center, which included a church, while we waited for the container to arrive. After 10 a.m. came and went, we all started to get a little anxious. This was our last day in Honduras. We were working on a tight schedule. We had to unload the truck, put together the sawmill, and train the people in the village all before 6 p.m. when it got dark. Partly to ease my growing anxiety, I went back into the church only to encounter a prayer group in session. I joined my prayers with theirs. Truck arrived at last.
Not here.
Yeah, how about that?
Oh,
thank God.
The unloading began. There were no forklifts here. Everything, and I mean everything, was unloaded by hand in 100-degree heat, including a refrigerator and stove, various wood shop equipment, 20 sewing machines, and over 200 bicycles. Everything had to be removed in order to get to the sawmill, and the driver had only been paid to stay for 2 hours. After numerous helping hands unloaded the truck, we finally reached the sawmill. Now we just had to figure out how to get this 1,000-pound machine off the truck.
No, ahora necesita levantarse más de aquí.
After all our hard work, Diane treated us to an ice cream break. We took the sawmill back to Scott and Diane's for final assembly.
And then what goes down on it?
One more square washer goes on once you put it up through this.
Up on, but it's on top of here, right?
Yeah. Square washers on top of this, then on top of this, hex or hex washer. Square nuts on top of this and hex nuts on top of that.
So the nut goes up against here?
Yeah, the square nut.
On, it's over here.
Couldn't you loosen this bolt?
Finally, around 3 p.m., we were on the road to the village with a sawmill to do training. We were able to get some training accomplished before night fell. What did we learn in Honduras? Patience, patience, patience. What did we see in Honduras? A beautiful country and beautiful people. As the sun set on our last day in Honduras, we felt we'd accomplished our main goal, but still felt there was much to do. Hopefully we'll get a chance to return. A full spirit got me looking.